push down one or more of the keys to make like patterns on paper, like for example, like this. That's a P.
Braille is a code, and it's based on 6 dots. And there are 3 dots on the left side and 3 dots on the right side. Depending on which one of those dots are raised depends on what the letter is. Contracted Braille is going to have specific symbols that are combinations of letters. If you want to do the T-I-O-N, you would use, instead of having to use 4 letters, it's a 2-cell image.
It's a rhyming poem. I like to eat. I like to drink. My favorite color is pink.
The Unified English Braille, it's actually in some ways made Braille easier in that it's much more like regular printed materials now. An example of that is those words and, for, of, the, with. At one time, if they occurred together in a sentence, such as and the, you would not leave a space between them. Now we follow the same thing that a print rule does, that every single word is separated by spaces.
6 plus 8 equals 14.
Okay, write that down.
I got it.
Probably the most negative thing I see is the limited amount of materials that are out there at this point in time. It really does mean that school districts that have current curriculum already in Braille, those have to be redone over again. It means all the state exams have to be done over again.
Since I have a lot of the older students who have been doing Braille for a long time, I've been getting some backlash from them. Why do we have to change? It's fine the way it is. I like doing it this way.
So now we're beginning the process of taking things that are already in our Braille system, because they've been Brailled previously to this, and changing it over to the UEB and then re-putting them back out again. And that's going to have to be done across everything. I mean, it's not just schools.